No one has used the warehouses of Crapper's Cove for years, officially anyway. Rumor has it that some of the local smugglers used the shacks as a rendezvous point under cover of night. This building looked abandoned from the outside, but once inside, you can see signs of recent habitation. In fact, you can hear muffled voices from the next room. A muffled shout can be heard from one of the rooms above you. For help as you burst into the room. The prisoner tells you that his captors interrogated him about a strange script he couldn't read. He says that the other captive was taken down through the basement and into a cavern. Thank you. door creaks open down on the main floor. Dank air wafts up from the lower level of the building. The door opens, and a gust of cool, damp air billows out. Scratching and squeaking can be heard from deeper inside the cavern. Thank you. Two corridors lie to the east and west. The door to the eastern hallway is open, while the locked door to the west has three dim crystals above it.
Thank you.
halfling woman stands nearby, reading a book. The halfling tells you that members of the Brotherhood interrogated her in a nearby building. She fears that they're trying to summon a great evil. A series of gears click in the distance, and a loud thunk reverberates through the cavern. The faint sound of chanting can be heard from deeper inside the building. You can hear chanting in the distance as you enter the building. chanting halts. An angry form materializes inside the summoning circle. Chamber floor to collapse. A coffin lies in the corner of this dusty crypt, covered in arcane wards. Asks you to free him, but you decide that there must have been a good reason for the thing to be bound inside its coffin. Best to let sleeping apparitions lie.